Yes, no, can you guys code? Guys, I mean answer. Can you guys code using all the example? Okay, you can try. That's very good. What about others? Good. Raghav, can you do that? Can you, like, are you comfortable enough? Okay. So let's move forward, that is good. The next example which I have here is, again, I mean, you see here, this Hello World IMPL service. Now, what this service is all about. So if you remember, this ad web service client was not out there earlier, right? This was not out there earlier. It has been defined like right now, right? And this class is generated by Jax AWS RM. So this is something which is generated by Jax AWS itself, right? And this is nothing but a normal interface, right? And this is your Hello World client. And this, we can see what is different. But if you draw a parallel between these two projects, right? You have Hello World client as seen. The contents of Hello World client we can see later, like what is different. But that is seen. Then the Hello World publisher is missing here. And then you have Hello World is there. Then a new Hello World IMPL service is there in place of Hello World IMPL. So, the thing is that this new project, Web Services tab, what I wanted to show was that here, it is using only, like, this is not the server-side program. This is not the server-side project. This is the client-side, right? This is a client-side. So, one way to access it, we discussed here, this Hello World client. The other way to access it is what is being defined here. So the same code can go over here also, that's not a problem, right? But I just wanted to show that there is a separate way also to access the service. And this thing, this is actual port, so this will go anywhere, this will be here as well, right? And this is nothing but, it's called as, and let's see this class, it's called as stub, okay? Now if you see here, it has everything, it has like, what is the name of the what is the name of the service, right? And like say like normal classes, then you have like if you get the port, what to return, like say with the queue name and the actual class name, and then everything. So here if you see, it is actually working on it gets you a reference of the port, right? So at the end you have to get the reference of the port itself, right? Because there only you can go and start like executing the service, because port is actually the one which is going to send the request over to the actual URL, right? And the stub actually does like the local work for you. Do not have to create a service and the queue name, right? So here what we are doing is that we are creating a URL, queue name, then service from there, and then getting a port. So all these things is redundant. I mean actually this is being taken care in this stub class itself. You have the URL and you have the way to get the port, right? So this much is done. So you just need to work on this particular part. So if you see the example which is out there, the client example, so what it does is that it uses the stub, right? So this is a stub which is out there, right? And from this stub you get the port because that method is already available. And then you execute it. So you do not need to create a service on your own. Those two, three lines are being saved. And the thing is that this thing, as far as I'm aware, in some way. So this handle resolver which is there that you can set. And that works in a similar way as handler chain. So it can be used to set a new URL. So if you want to change a URL from here, that you can do using handler resolver. So just wanted to say that there are two different ways to access the same part, the same service, but this is available and accessible using this way it's also, right? So the second way is via client side stub class. You do not have to
create service and URL classes, right? So that is the point which we wanted to bring home. See, and this side implementation should not be there because we're hitting on a different side itself. This is a stub, this is actual port, which has to be there. I mean, the port you need, right? Now let's try to execute it. So you're getting an exception, right? So the, what is exception? Failed to access AWS in this particular location. Why? First question is why. So the why is, first of all, there are two things to be noted here. One thing is, if I go here and see. The URL is 9999. But if you remember, my service would be available here, but I mean, it would not be intercepted. But if interception is not required, that is okay. But the service is stopped also, like I stopped it. So let's start it again. So this is what I'm starting right now, as part of the server side code. Now this is started, right? And to verify it, you can always go back and run this. So this is up, it means that this is getting accessed. Right? Now from back here and then running it. See, this is coming up fine. So this me, and if you see, there's no relationship. Guys, can you hear me? Yeah, I can just confirm once more. Aarti, Raghav, Shala, can you guys hear me? Hello.
Yes, we can.
Yeah, sorry about that. I saw a message where it said that it's not. The audio connection is experiencing some difficulty. That's why I rechecked.
Yeah, there is a little noise.
Okay, anyways, let's continue. So this is how, we code for it. So if you see, there is no relationship between this particular project and this particular project, right? So this is what can go in a separate computer also. I mean, that's the way it is done. Right? So, I mean, you can have two different applications, one is in one place, the other in the other place, and then either using the stub or using the client, the port, you can actually run the program, and then it actually goes over to the server, it gets you the details, and then comes back to you. So there are two different ways to run the same stuff, and even if this one, there's no relationship, but if you want, you can move it here, and I just want to show that there is no relationship between the two projects also. So that you know that, there is no relationship, right? See, this is also working fine. So there are two different ways, and there is no relationship between the client side and the server side code. So that is a point which you wanted to bring home. Okay. Now the second thing which you want to look at is the style. So if you come here and see, the style is RPC. So RPC stands for remote procedure call. So there are other style also available, which is document, right? So the difference between RPC and the document is that in the case of RPC, like right now we are using RPC. So if you see here, the request XML here, right? So this request XML has the name of the operation as well. Get hello world as string, right? And the name of the output also. But if you use, document style, the name of the operation as such doesn't appear. So that is what is the difference between remote procedure call and the document style. So the document style is easy to validate via XSD, which is difficult because some redundant tags are there, like some SOAP envelope tags are, like if you see here, these SOAP envelope tags are also there, which is difficult to validate since there is no corresponding XSD for it. So that's the reason, nowadays people prefer document over RPC. But the thing is that there is no one validates XML that much. That is just a theoretical concept. And second of all, like from a development perspective, it's same for you. You just have to change the style here. So it doesn't matter much. Okay. So that's what I wanted to say. Any questions till now?